Good morning students. Today our topic is database management system, and this is unit 3 of our syllabus. So let's start. First of all, what is data? Actually, database management system is a combination of three words: database, management and system. So first of all, we have to understand data and database. So what is data? Data is a collection of facts and figures that can be processed to produce information. We already studied the definition of data and information in computer fundamental part, which is a unit 1. So data is basically, we can say that raw facts, figures and statistics which we insert into a computer system is called the data. So data may be image, it may be a word, any word or numbers, or it may be a sound. So data is a collection of facts and figures that can be processed to produce information. And what is information? Information is the processed data. So whatever we get after the processing of a data is called the information. So I think the difference between the data and information is quite clear to all of you. So data becomes information when it is processed, and the processed data is called the information. So we can say that processed data is called the information. So raw facts, figures, statistics which we insert into the computer is called the data, and after processing whatever we get is called the information. Suppose there are two numbers 5 and 7. So we have to add two we have to find out the sum of these two numbers. So we give 5 and 7. We insert number 5 and 7 through keyboard to computer system, and now at the point of time 5 and 7 are data, and the result whatever we get after the addition, that is 12, is called the information. So that is the information. And next time, if you want to add 2, then actually 14 is the information and 2 is the data. So we cannot say that 12 is the information or 12 is the data. Okay. So it depends on that whether we have to insert the data or whether that is the final result. So if that is a final result or the process data is called the information. In this case, process data is the data after we get processing is 14. So 14 is a information and 12 is a basically data. So the raw facts, figures and statistics is called the data, and the information is nothing but only the process data. So these are the different forms of the data representation. You can easily see here: word, image, numbers and sound. Next is database. So what is database? Database is nothing but only the systematic collection of data. Systematic collection of data. And what is DBMS? DBMS stands for Database Management System. In simple word, we can say that database is nothing but only the interrelated data. So interrelated data is called the database, such as your phone book, in which there are numbers of your friends, contact number of your friends and their names. So it is also called a database. Okay, so it is called a database. So database is nothing but only the systematic collection of the data, or we can say that interrelated data is called the database. And what is DBMS? When database is managed through a software, it is called a database management system. So very simple definition: when database is managed through a software, and when we say that manage, it means we are able to create a data a database, we are able to insert certain data in a database, we have a right to delete a data in a database. So these types of operation we can perform, then that is called through a software, that is called that it is called a DBMS, database management system. So DBMS, first of all, it stands for database management system, or in simple words we can say that DBMS is a DBMS nothing but only the database managed through a software is called the DBMS. So you can easily see that when DBMS can be divided into two parts: database and management systems. So system means a software that manages the database is called the DBMS. In simple words we can say that. So I think both of the term are quite clear to all of you: database and database management system, DBMS and database. So database is nothing but only the collection of interrelated data, and database is database management system is the software which basically manages the database. So such subtype of softwares are MySQL, Oracle, MS Access. These are some database management systems. Now let's see the points. Database is the collection of interrelated data, and management system is a set of programs to store and retrieve those data. And based on this, we can define DBMS like this, that DBMS is a collection of interrelated data and set of programs to store and access those data in an easy and effective manner. So in simple words, that is the simplest definition of DBMS. Database management system is a software that is used to manage the database. Database management system is a software that is used to manage the database. Now, there is a difference between database and database management system. I think it is already explained. You can easily see on the screen. So, first of all, data, the collection of related facts and figures is called the data. And collection of interrelated data is called the database, and software used to maintain database is called the database management system. Now I think all these terms are clear to all of you. So what are the advantage of DBMS? First of all, why we use DBMS? So first advantage is multiple user interface. It means many users can access similar database. Second thing is redundancy control, means there is we can avoid duplication of data, so no double copy is permitted. Third is backup and recovery. The DBMS provides backup after failure. And next is authorized access. Only authorized user can access database. Only authorized users can access database. So these are the some advantages why we use DBMS. In simple words, we can say that more than one user can use database. DBMS reduce data duplication. DBMS provides a data backup recovery options, and DBMS also provides a security, and only after that authorized user can access the database. So that's why we use a DBMS. And the disadvantage of the database is concerned. Complexity, it is very sometimes it is very complicated. Except MySQL, which is open source license, DBMS are generally costly. So MySQL is open source, otherwise all other softwares are licensed. You have to take a license for that software, and they are very large in size also. And some examples of DBMS are there. These are the example of DBMS: Microsoft Access, well-known name, then MySQL, MySQL Server, Oracle Database, Sybase, IBM DB2, PostgreSQL, Amazon Simple Database, which is a cloud-based. So these are the some example of DBMS, Database Management System. And this is a diagram which shows the interaction between the user, DBMS, and a database. So you can easily see here, that is the user, then DBMS, and then database. So first point is user makes a request for the information, then through DBMS software, DBMS searches the database, and then there is an arrow from DBMS to database which says that DBMS retrieve the information, and then there is a arrow from DBMS to user which says that DBMS returns information to the user. So that is the whole functionality of the DBMS. So basically we can say that user send a request to a DBMS to search for a particular type of information or data, then DBMS search in the database, means the software search in a database, and then that data, then data is if find if there is a data according to the user search, then DBMS finally retrieve that information or data and give to this information data to the user. So that is the whole functionality of the system. So three main parts are here: user, DBMS, and database. Next is component of DBMS. What are the different components of DBMS? So basically, DBMS system can be divided into five major components, and these are hardware, software, data, procedure, and database access language. And this is called database SQL language. Access language is called SQL, means structured query language, which is essential part of DBMS. So hardware, software, data, procedures, and database access language, these are the components of a DBMS. And the diagram explain this concept of database management system. The in code you can easily see that hardware is there, and different softwares are there to access. And you can easily see that user, from user to this box hardware and software, there is an arrow and which procedure is written here. And also there is an arrow point towards from user to hardware, and data is written, and the point that is written on that arrow is the database access language. And two points are there, that is called the data. So the basic thing is that is our system, computer system. And we know that a computer system can be divided into two basic parts, hardware and software. So basically, these are the hardwares, and that is the system softwares, or we can say that operating system that manages the hardwares. And here we are, means user. So user can request to computer system via procedure or database access language, means using SQL, to retrieve the information. So that is the whole process of our database management system. And database access language itself contain data. So these two points are also there. So user can send a request to the system using procedure or database access language. So a detailed description is here. DBMS components, hardware. When we say hardware, we means computer hard disk, input output channels for data, and any other physical component. And DBMS component software, this is a program which control everything. The DBMS software is capable of understanding the database access language and interpret it into the actual database command to execute them on the database. Next is data. Data is that resource for which DBMS was designed. To motive behind the creation of DBMS was to store and utilize data. Next is procedures. Procedures refers to the general instructions. So procedures nothing but only the general instructions. We can say that in simple words, to use a database management system. And this include procedures to set up and install a DBMS, to log in and log out of a DBMS software, to manage database, to take backups or generating reports, etc. Next is database access language. So database access language is a simple language designed to write command to access, insert, update, and delete data stored in any database. And a user can write command in the database access language and submit it to the DBMS for execution, which is then translated and executed by the DBMS. And SQL is a standard language for accessing and manipulating databases. SQL is refers for structured query language, and that is a DBMS language is used to accessing and manipulating database. One more thing is that there is a branch of DBMS known as RDBMS, means Relational Database Management System. R refers for Relational Database Management System. R here is for relational. And what is a relation? Relation means we can say that in simple words, table. So basically, in RDBMS, data is stored in the forms of a table, in which there are certain rows and columns, which we call the tuple and attributes. So name of the columns are called the attributes, and rows are called the tuples. And most of the modern systems, DBMS systems, is like MySQL, Oracle, MS Access. These are the example of RDBMS. All these are the examples of RDBMS. Or most of the and all these RDBMS follows, and SQL is the part of all these RDBMS. So SQL stands for Structured Query Language, which is a database language. Which is a database language by which we are able to create or manipulate data in a database. So this is a very important question sometimes asked in examination, that what is the difference between DBMS and RDBMS. So DBMS refers for database management system, in which there are a collection of interrelated data which are accessed by a software. And if the data is stored in the form of a table, then it is called the relational database management system. Relation means table. So the three terms are there: relation, attribute, and tuple. Relation means table, attribute means column, and tuple for row. So these points will be discussed later on in this video, or maybe in the next video. But here I give you just introduction part of these terms, because these are very important to understand, and maybe it may be asked in examination also. So always remember that RDBMS stands for Relational Database Management System. And all these modern systems, such like the SQL, MySQL, or Oracle, MS Access, these are all are the example of RDBMS. Next is users. So now let us talk about the users. First of all, database administrator. There are three types of users of a database management system. These are database administrators, then application program or a system or a software developer, and third is end user. So database administrators, the database administrator, or sometimes called as a DBA, is the one who manages the complete database management system, and DBA takes care of the security of the database and its availability, managing the license key, managing user account and access. So database administrator are the person who overall manage the database. So it basically secure the database, manage the license key, managing user accounts, different user accounts, and their access. So it also provide access to a database or a part of a database. So that is a work of a database administrators. Then second is application programmer or software developer. These user groups is involved in developing and designing the part of the database management system. So those person who basically design or develop a DBMS, or are involved in developing and designing a part of DBMS, are called the application programmer or software developer. And third is end user. So end user are the one who store, retrieve, and update and delete data. In simple words, the user of the DBMS is called the end user. So the end users are the one who store, retrieve, update, and delete data. And our next point is DBMS schema. So what is schema? So in one line we can say that overall database design is called the database schema, or overall database structure is called the database schema. So that is a definition, simplest definition of the DBMS schema. As you can see on the screen, that design of a database इज कॉल्ड द स्कीमा। और स्कीमा इज ऑफ थ्री टाइप्स, फिजिकल स्कीमा, लॉजिकल स्कीमा एंड वी स्कीमा। एंड सेकेंड टर्म इज डी बी एम एस इंस्टेंस। सो द डेटा इज स्टोर्ड इन डी बी डेटाबेस एट अ पर्टिकुलर मोमेंट ऑफ टाइम इज कॉल्ड द इंस्टेंस ऑफ द डेटाबेस। दैट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड इट इज़ आस्क्ड सो मेनी नंबर ऑफ टाइम्स ऑफ एग्जामिनेशन दैट वट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन स्कीमा एंड इंस्टेंस, वट इज स्कीमा इंस्टेंस। सो स्कीमा इज ओवरऑल डेटाबेस डिजाइन एंड डेटा स्टोर्ड इन अ डेटाबेस एट अ पर्टिकुलर मोमेंट ऑफ टाइम इज कॉल्ड द इंस्टेंस ऑफ द डेटाबेस। And the three schema architecture is also called ANSI architecture or three level architecture. And this framework is used to describe the structure of a specific database system. And the three schema architecture is also used to separate the user, application and physical database. The three schema architecture contain three levels and it breaks the database down into three different categories. That's why these are called the database schema. So in simple words, first of all, there are two terms, schema and instance. Schema is nothing but only the overall database design is called the schema. It has three parts or three types of schema there: physical schema, logical schema and view schema. And second term is instance. So the data stored in a database at a particular moment of time is called the instance of a database. And the architecture which shows the schema is called the three level architecture, in which there are three levels which represent physical schema, logical schema and view schema. So let us see the diagram which gives you a clear idea. That is a three schema or three level architecture and it is also asked in examination so many number of times. So this gives you a clear idea. First of all, as you know that schema is nothing but only the overall database design, and the design of a database can be divided into three basic parts: physical or and conceptual and internal. External, conceptual and internal schema. External schema is also called the view. Okay, conceptual is also called as logical. And internal also called as a physical. So three types of schema are there, you can easily see on screen. Internal is also called as physical, conceptual is also called as logical, and external schema is also called as a view schema. So physical, logical and view. So this is physical, this is logical and this is view. These are the other three names of physical, logical and view level schema, also called as internal schema, conceptual schema or external schema. So this is the physical schema. In your diagram you can see here, this is logical schema, also called as the conceptual schema, and that is called the user level schema or called the external schema. And you can easily see here the mapping is also there. So both are in all of these are interrelated to each other. You can easily see that there is an arrow from internal level to conceptual level, and this arrow is bidirectional. And then there is also an arrow from conceptual level to external level, and this is also bidirectional. Okay, means you can see that the direction of the arrow is this type, and that is of our DBMS. So this is a three schema architecture, three level schema architecture. And the point should be remembered that internal schema is called the physical schema, conceptual schema is also known as logical schema, and external schema is also called as view level schema. And there is a mapping of all the schema to each other, and there is a order, first of all physical schema, then logical or conceptual schema, and then after external schema is there. So what is the meaning of इंटरनल लेवल और इंटरनल स्कीमा, और विच इज़ ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज अ फिजिकल स्कीमा. द इंटरनल लेवल हैज़ द इंटरनल स्कीमा विच डिस्क्राइब द फिजिकल स्टोरेज स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द डेटा बेस एंड इट इज़ यूज टू डिफाइन दैट हाउ द डेटा विल बी स्टोर्ड इन अ ब्लॉक. सो इन सिंपल वर्ड्स यू कैन से दैट फिजिकल स्कीमा बेसिकली डिस्क्राइब हाउ द डेटा विल बी स्टोर्ड इन अ DBMS. देन सेकेंड इज कॉन्सेप्चुअल स्कीमा विच इज़ ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज लॉजिकल स्कीमा एंड द कॉन्सेप्चुअल स्कीमा डिस्क्राइब द डिज़ाइन ऑफ डेटा बेस ऑफ द एट द कॉन्सेप्चुअल लेवल एंड द कॉन्सेप्चुअल लेवल डिस्क्राइब वाट डज आर द वाट डेटा आर टू बी स्टोर्ड इन द डेटा बेस वाट डेटा आर टू बी स्टोर्ड इन द डेटा बेस एंड ऑल्सो डिस्क्राइब वाट रिलेशनशिप एग्जिस्ट एमंग दोज डेटा एंड प्रोग्रामर्स एंड डेटा बेस एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर वर्क एट दिस लेवल. एंड थर्ड वन इज एक्सटर्नल लेवल और सब स्कीमा और इट इज़ ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज व्यू स्कीमा. तो थ्री नेम्स आर देयर, एक्सटर्नल स्कीमा, सब स्कीमा एंड और व्यू स्कीमा. तो द व्यू स्कीमा डिस्क्राइब द एंड यूजर इंटरेक्शन विद द डेटा बेस सिस्टम, मीन्स हाउ यूजर कैन व्यू द डेटा बेस. सो वी कैन सी दैट थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ स्कीमा देयर, फिजिकल, लॉजिकल एंड एक्सटर्नल मीन्स व्यू स्कीमा. फिजिकल स्कीमा सेज हाउ द डेटा विल बी स्टोर्ड इन अ डेटा बेस. कॉन्सेप्चुअल स्कीमा टेल्स वॉट डेटा हैज़ टू बी स्टोर्ड इन द डेटा बेस. एंड एक्सटर्नल लेवल और व्यू स्कीमा से व्यू स्कीमा डिस्क्राइब द एंड यूजर इंटरेक्शन विद द डेटा बेस सिस्टम. नेक्स्ट टर्म इज कॉल्ड द डेटा इंडिपेंडेंस. सो द डेटा इंडिपेंडेंस रिफर्स कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ बींग एबल टू मॉडिफाई द स्कीमा एट वन लेवल ऑफ द डेटा बेस सिस्टम विदाउट अल्टरिंग द स्कीमा एट द नेक्स्ट हाई लेवल. सो इफ यू चेंज स्कीमा एट वन लेवल दैट डजेंट अफेक्ट द स्कीमा एट अनदर लेवल, दैट इज कॉल्ड द डेटा इंडिपेंडेंस. सो द फर्स्ट टाइप ऑफ चेंज इन अ डेटा बेस स्कीमा इज कॉल्ड द डेटा इंडिपेंडेंस. So there are two types of data independence. First is logical data independence and second is physical data independence. And it is also very important questions and asked so many number of times in the examination that what do you mean by data independence or what are the different types of data independence. So first of all, logical data independence. Logical data independence refers characteristics of being able to change the conceptual schema without having to change the external schema. And if we do any changes in the conceptual view of the data, then the user view of the data would not be affected. So it means simply that, see the diagram, if you made a change at this level, means at the conceptual level or at the logical level of your database management system, then there is no effect on external schema. Then this means that there is no effect, means they are unchanged. Then this type of data independence is called the logical data independence. And second things, if you made a change at this level, means at physical level, then this type of changes does not affect at conceptual level, then this type of this type of data independence is called the physical data independence. So now I think both of the term are clear to all of you. So logical data independence refers characteristics of being able to change the conceptual schema without having to change the external schema. So if we do any changes in the conceptual view of the data, then the user view of the data would not be affected. And the second is physical data independence. So physical data independence can be defined as a capacity to change the internal schema without having to change the conceptual schema. And if we do any changes in the storage size of the database system server, then the conceptual structure of the database will not be affected. So these are the two types of data independence, logical data independence and physical data independence. And in simple words, if you made a change at logical level, then that changes does not affect at view level, that is called the logical data independence. And if you made a change at physical level, then that changes doesn't affect on logical data, logical level, that is called the physical data independence. So these are the two basic types of data independence: logical data independence and physical data independence. Now you can easily see that in the diagram. This is physical data independence, means if you made a change at this level, then there is no effect on logical level. And if you make a change at logical level, then external level, there is no effect on external level, then that is called the logical data independence. And that is our stored database. So thanks for watching this video.